Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications. We upload daily, and check the source of this video to view all the images and videos if there was any. Former UN Secretary-General Kofi Annan has died at the age of 80 after a short illness. Mr. Annan spent his final days at his home in Geneva, Switzerland, with his wife Nane and children Ama, Kojo, and Nina. He was the first Black African to become UN Secretary-General, a role he held between 1997 and 2006. Former UN Secretary-General Kofi Annan, pictured, has died at the age of 80 after a short illness. The Nobel Peace Prize laureate went on to chair the Elders, a group set up by Nelson Mandela, pictured together in 2007, which aims to promote global peace and human rights. Mr. Annan was the chief architect of what became known as the Millennium Development Goals, and played a central role in creating the Global Fund to Fight AIDS, Tuberculosis and Malaria and the UN's first counter-terrorism strategy. In 2001, the celebrated diplomat, who was born in Kumasi, Ghana, was a co-recipient of the Nobel Peace Prize with the UN for prioritizing human rights in the role. The committee also praised Mr. Annan for his efforts to help contain the spread of the HIV virus in Africa as well as opposition to international terrorism. Ghana's national flag will fly at half-mast across the country for an entire week from Monday in tribute to Mr. Annan. Kofi Annan was a guiding force for good, current UN Secretary-General Antonio Guterres said today. A black ribbon and a bouquet of flowers adorn Kofi Annan's portrait upon news of his death. His portrait at UN headquarters is New York sits between his predecessor Boutros Ghali and successor Ban Ki-moon. It is with profound sadness that I learned of his passing. In many ways, Kofi Annan was the United Nations. He rose through the ranks to lead the organization into the new millennium with matchless dignity and determination. Tributes have poured in for Mr. Annan from across the world. Prime Minister Theresa May said, "Sad to hear of the death of Kofi Annan. A great leader and reformer of the UN, he made a huge contribution to making the world he has left a better place than the one he was born into. My thoughts and condolences are with his family," Labour leader Jeremy Corbyn added. Kofi Annan dedicated his life to building a more just and peaceful world. His efforts in support of conflict resolution and human rights will be remembered. A black ribbon reading, "In Memoriam," was tied across the left corner of his portrait to mark his death. A visitor to the United Nations pauses in front of a different portrait of Annan at UN headquarters on the day of his death. The UN flag flew at half-staff outside the organization's headquarters in New York. "He looked for a peaceful path when others looked for war. My thoughts are with his family and loved ones." Nana Addo Dankwa Akufo-Addo, the president of Ghana, paid tribute to Mr. Annan on Twitter. He wrote, "The government and people of Ghana, First Lady Rebecca and I are deeply saddened by the news of the death, in Bern, Switzerland, of one of our greatest compatriots, Mr. Kofi Annan. I extend, on behalf of the entire Ghanaian nation, our sincere, heartfelt condolences to his beloved widow, Nane Maria, and to his devoted children, Ama, Kojo and Nina, on this great loss." Mr. Annan, pictured here with Bob Geldof and Bono, previously said that his darkest moment was the Iraq War and his inability to stop it. His uncontested election to a second term as Secretary-General was unprecedented, reflecting the overwhelming support he enjoyed from both rich and poor countries. Pictured with George Clooney in 2006, "I am, however, comforted by the information, after speaking to Nane Maria, that he died peacefully in his sleep." Consummate international diplomat and highly respected former Secretary-General of the United Nations, Mr. Kofi Annan was the first from sub-Saharan Africa to occupy this exalted position. He brought considerable renown to our country by this position and through his conduct and comportment in the global arena. He was an ardent believer in the capacity of the Ghanaian to chart his or her own course onto the path of progress and prosperity. Undoubtedly, he excelled in the various undertakings of his life, leaving in his trail most pleasant memories. His was a life well lived. I have directed that, in his honor, Ghana's national flag will fly at half-mast across the country and in all of Ghana's diplomatic missions across the world, from Monday 20 August 2018 for 1 week. Rest in perfect peace, Kofi. You have earned it. God bless. New Zealand Prime Minister Jacinda Ardern tweeteth, "The world has lost a great humanitarian, leader, and self-proclaimed, stubborn optimist." Rest in peace, Kofi Annan. Former Australian PM Kevin Rudd added, "The world has lost a great leader today." Kofi initiated the Millennium Development Goals. He did everything possible to prevent the Iraq War. He spoke for our common humanity. I will miss him too as a dear friend, colleague and source of encouragement. Narendra Modi, the Prime Minister of India, said, "We express our profound sorrow at the passing away of Nobel laureate and former UNSG Mr. Kofi Annan. The world has lost not only a great African diplomat and humanitarian but also a conscience keeper of international peace and security." Tributes have poured in for Mr. Annan across the world, and Nana Akufo-Addo, the president of Ghana, has announced that the national flag will fly at half-mast for a week. Tony Blair tweeted, "I'm shocked and distressed to hear the news about Kofi. He was a good friend whom I saw only weeks ago. Kofi Annan was a great diplomat, a true statesman and a wonderful colleague who was widely respected and will be greatly missed. My deepest sympathy to Nane and his family." US President Donald Trump has not yet paid tribute to Mr. Annan. Mr. Annan took on the top UN post 6 years after the collapse of the Soviet Union and presided during a decade when the world united against terrorism after the September 11th attacks. "I think that my darkest moment was the Iraq War, and the fact that we could not stop it," Annan said in a February 2013 interview with Time magazine to mark the publication of his memoir. "Could you imagine if the UN had endorsed the war in Iraq, what our reputation would be like?" Although at that point, President Bush said the UN was headed toward irrelevance because we had not supported the war. But now we know better. Mr. Annan's uncontested election to a second term was unprecedented, reflecting the overwhelming support he enjoyed from both rich and poor countries, despite challenges from the outset. During his tenure as Secretary-General, Mr. Annan presided over some of the worst failures and scandals at the world body, one of its most turbulent periods since its founding in 1945. His enduring moral prestige remained largely undented, however, both through charisma and by virtue of having negotiated with most of the powers in the world. When he departed from the United Nations, he left behind a global organization far more aggressively engaged in peacekeeping and fighting poverty, setting the framework for the UN's 21st century response to mass atrocities and its emphasis on human rights and development. A statement from the Kofi Annan Foundation earlier today said, "Wherever there was suffering and need, he reached out and touched many people with his deep compassion and empathy. He selflessly placed others first, radiating genuine kindness, warmth and brilliance in all he did. He will be greatly missed by so many around the world, as well as his staff at the foundation and his many former colleagues in the United Nations system. He will remain in our hearts forever." Tributes have poured in for Mr. Annan, pictured here with the Queen in 2007. From across the world, the Kofi Annan Foundation described Mr. Annan, pictured here with Angelina Jolie in 2003, as a deeply committed internationalist who worked tirelessly for the cause of peace. After stepping down from his role in the United Nations, Mr. Annan set up the Kofi Annan Foundation, a not-for-profit organization that aims to promote better global governance. He also chaired the Elders, a group of elder statesmen founded by Nelson Mandela that promote global peace and human rights. His foundation described Mr. Annan as a deeply committed internationalist who worked tirelessly for the cause of peace. In his memoir, Annan recognized the costs of taking on the world's top diplomatic job, joking that SG, for Secretary General, also signified scapegoat around UN headquarters. Just before becoming Secretary General, Mr. Annan served as UN peacekeeping chief and as special envoy to the former Yugoslavia, where he oversaw a transition in Bosnia from UN protective forces to NATO-led troops. The UN peacekeeping operation faced two of its greatest failures during his tenure, the Rwanda genocide in 1994, and the massacre in the Bosnian town of Srebrenica in July 1995. In both cases, the UN had deployed troops under Mr. Annan's command, but they failed to save the lives of the civilians they were mandated to protect. As Secretary General, Annan forged his experiences into a doctrine called the responsibility to protect that countries accepted, at least in principle, to head off genocide, crimes against humanity, ethnic cleansing and war crimes. In 1998, he helped ease a transition to civilian rule in Nigeria and visited Iraq to try to resolve its impasse with the Security Council over compliance with weapons inspections and other matters. The FA helped avoid an outbreak of hostilities that seemed imminent at the time. In 1999, he was deeply involved in the process by which East Timor gained independence from Indonesia and started the Global Compact initiative that has grown into the world's largest effort to promote corporate social responsibility.